highly expectant of nightmare draws, poker games, escape appointments, and oh, I nearly forgot that there is a possible split between two parties who enjoyed some love some time ago. These and many more are ready to be served on your plate via Sport Zone on Tech TV. My name is Kelvin Owusu-Anza. Now let's move on to the President's Cup. That is where the two British rivals in Ghana, Kumasi Asante Kotoko and Akaa Sefo, are expected to engage in a battle on July 1st. And South African sports broadcast giant SuperSport TV has earned the right to telecast live the match that will be played at the Accra Sports Stadium. The two sides have agreed to earn a sum of 50,000 Ghana cedis before they engage in the game. The two clubs will be facing off as they faced off earlier in the month of May in the Ghana Premier League, where Sulama Abdullahi Haula gifted Kumasi Asante Kotoko a solitary one-goal victory over Accra Hassopoulos. Kumasi Asante Kotoko have officially lodged a complaint to the Ghana Football Association Ethics Committee against Bechem United's PRO, judging that he spells spurious allegations against the chairman of the club, that is Samuel Opokunti, and the club sponsors MTN, as they lost the MTN FA Cup quarterfinals to the Bechem outfit. The PRO, in a radio interview after the Kotoko Bechem United MTN FA Cup round of 8 match in Kumasi last Sunday, purported that general manager Samuel Opokunti came up with Bechem United to play a match of convenience. The Phobians, who have mutually parted ways with Kenichi Yashuashi, are without a coach ahead of the resumption of the ongoing 2015-2016 Ghana Premier League. The Portuguese Tragul, who arrived in the country to handle the Phobians youth team, is being rumored to be confirmed by the Haas team as the substantive coach of Accra Hassopoulos. Maybe David Duncan is free now. Hassopoulos could definitely appoint him as one of their new coaches. Now to the 2018 draw that would come up in Cairo in Egypt. That is the African draw for the 2018 World Cup to be staged in Russia. The draw will be held on Friday in CAF headquarters in Cairo. 20 nations will be drawn into 5 groups of 4 each to play on home and away basis from October 2016 to November 2017, with the nation that ends up at the summit of the table and in the qualification to play in the Mundial. Now let's move on to the foreign front. Well, in the Copa America Centenary, Argentina, led by captain Lionel Andres Messi, have earned qualification to their second successive final in the competition. Let's not forget, this competition is being staged in the United States of America to mark the 100th anniversary of the Copa America. The Argentine shot into the lead after 3 minutes through Ezequiel Lavezzi. Captain Lionel Messi doubled the lead with an excellently struck free kick before Napoli's Gonzalo Higuain capped a brilliant night for the Albacelestes. Will now be facing either of Colombia or Chile in the finals, and that will be a very cagey encounter, as two Argentine coaches will be expected to make the final. And now to the Euros in France. That is where Spain, after 12 years unbeaten run in the Euros, have suffered a defeat courtesy Luka Modric Croatia in a 2-1 defeat on Tuesday night. The Spaniards, who were presented with the opportunity to grab the lead again in the game through a penalty after Silva had been brought down in the box, but Sergio Ramos, who stepped up for the kick, had his efforts saved. The Croats claimed victory late in the game after Ivan Perisic's 87th minute low drive to the first post beat goalkeeper David De Gea in post. Spain will now have to meet Italy in the round of 16 after placing second with 6 points to Croatia, who had 7 points. Well, this is how we end it on Sport Zone. Hope you enjoyed your diet that was served on your plate via Sport Zone. My name is Kelvin Owusu-Anza. Let's get interactive on our social media handles at TechTVGH on Twitter, TechTV on Facebook, and also our Instagram handle, TechTVGH. Enjoy the rest of the programs on TechTV.